in equivalent fractions. Finding missing numbers in equivalent fractions. Now, I've told you equivalent fractions are equal fractions. But in this aspect of it, there are going to be missing number, maybe a numerator or denominator. So we are to find them. I have 1 all over 2 equals to dash all over 6. Now for our level, I'm going to teach us a simple method to go about it. Now, if you look at it, you have numerator here, there's no numerator here. Here you have denominator and you have denominator. That has given us clue on how to solve it. Okay? What do I do? You are going to ask yourself, what have we multiplied by 2 to get 6? What did we multiply by 2 to get 6? Or what you need to do is, let me give you 2 ways. What have we multiplied by 2? 2 times what? We give us 6. 2 times 3, we give us 6. That is 1. 2, we can say 6, this 6 divided by this 2. Okay? It will give us what? 3. It means they have used 3 to do what? To multiply these 2 to get 6. 2 times 3 is 6. How did we know? I use multiplication, I also use division. So it's either you can say this 6 divided by this 2, it will give you 3. It means that it's this 3 they used to multiply these 2 to get 6. That has given us a way out. So, you know, in equivalent fraction, it's either we divide with the same number or we multiply with the same number. So the same number we use for denominator is the same number we use for numerator. So I will just say this one here times 3, and that will give me 3. It means the missing number here is 3. Okay? It is very simple. Just study it, you will get it. I will give more examples. Now, here we have 2 all over 3 equals to 8 all over dash. We don't know the denominator here, but we know the numerator here. So I said in the first example, I said you can use your division to know it. You can ask yourself first, what have we multiplied by 2 to get 4? To know that, just say 8 divided by 2. What is 8 divided by 2? That is what? 4. Okay? It means 2 times 4 will give us what? 8. They have multiplied that with 4. And don't forget that in equivalent fraction, we multiply both numerator and denominator with the same number. That is if you want to multiply. You want to divide. We use the same number to divide both numerator and denominator. So, since I've known what they used to multiply this, 2 times 4, 8. So, I also use that 4 to multiply this. So, therefore, 3 times 4, that is 12. So, the missing number here is 12. Okay? 2 times 4, 8. 3 times 4, 12. Dash over 20. Just like we did earlier. What can we multiply with 10 to give us 20? We can also divide. You can say 20 divided by 10. That is 2. So 10 times 2 is equal to 20. That is how they arrive at this 20. Okay? So for us to get this, we also multiply this by what? 7. We now have 7 times 2. 7 times 2 will give us what? 14. Okay? That means the missing number here is 14. Now, let's do a kind of check. Let me multiply these two with the same number. If we are going to get 14 over 20, let's do what we call check. You can check your work out. Okay? So, you know, we are going to multiply the same number. 7 times 2 all over 10 times 2. 7 times 2, we have 14. And 10 times 2, we have 20. Okay, that is telling us that our answer is what? Correct. Don't forget that the same number we use for this is the same number we must use for the denominator. Okay, I want you to watch over and over again. You will get it very simple.